Game two now awaits at the Ralph in Grand Forks, North Dakota. Virginia Union and Lynn ready to do battle. Again, Brian has made it to the championship game, and this winner will face them for all of it. For Lynn, it's Cage, Faber, Wingard, who got in a lot of foul difficulties last night. Didn't play much. Hayes and Edwards. And back on the other end, rewarded with a basket by Sheldon Edwards. Good hop to the basket and rolled in by Sheldon Edwards.
Edwards himself, a great story. We said he's 28 years old. He is married, has a couple of kids, and also has his own car detailing business. He goes to school full time, he plays basketball full time, and has his own business. That number has improved. Looking inside, it's an open lane to the goal for Sheldon Edwards. We are at the break at game number two, Panthers 28, the Knights 24. Under pressure. Both teams in the meantime are on the floor and ready to go for the second half.
Well, again, I think that the key to this whole thing is going to be toughness. Each of these teams, I think, has to be a little bit leg weary. They both relied on their quickness in the game yesterday, so I think it's a matter of toughness here in the second half.
The game for a transition team, and there's a steal.
Jabber to the basket, the lead back to eight. Scott McMillan needs a break. Biggest lead of the night for Virginia Union at 51-37. But for the Knights, it's about to end. We have our two finalists, Brian from game one and Dave Robbins, and Virginia Union in game two.
Unfortunately, our season ended that night, but it didn't take away from the glory they had put together all season long.
You know, I just wish I had more time to play with those seniors, you know, because I've grown to love them, and you know, and it's I think it's mutual. You know, we've all bonded really well. And I told them after the Final Four loss, I said, you know, when I'm 60, and I'm gonna be proud to tell my kids that I've had an opportunity to play with you guys.
We have a great group of guys, and I think that's helped him you know, understand things, and I think it's helped Sheldon in terms of his work ethic, and I think that's going to be something that he's hopefully going to be able to carry with him after he you know, graduates here and has finished playing here at Lynn. It's been neat to watch because his situation is so unique, obviously, and it's been fun. I mean, I've enjoyed coaching Sheldon, I really have, and he's a coachable person for the most part, and he's really, I think, tried to, you know, grasp and tried to understand. And I think he wants to have success, and he wants his program to have success. And I think he's never taken for granted the situation that he's got in front of him. And maybe him being here has helped our other guys as well. And maybe, you know, help them understand how fortunate they really are and what they have and the opportunity that they do have. And I guess that's kind of been a byproduct of him being here.
It's sort of one of those stories you read about, you hear about, but we're living right through it. He's proof that regardless of your circumstance, you can make it. He's one of those guys you just feel like you know he's going to be all right. If he's able to make it right now, when he's finished with school and he doesn't have basketball and doesn't have school, my gosh, it's going to seem easy for him all of a sudden. He's going to make it. And he may make it in a big way. His wife and children are going to be proud of him. I think they're proud of him already. But those children, I hope someday when they watch this, are going to be really proud of their dad because of what their dad has sacrificed during this time to make a better life for them. They should be proud of their dad.
I could have, you know, I could have easily given up, you know, even not even since I've been here, since the time that I left high school. You know, I could have given up and say, you know, just forget it. But, you know, I've just learned, you know, not to give up. Pretty much, and not giving up has worked out for me. You know, so I like to be an inspiration for anybody who's watching. You know, because obviously I'm an older guy compared to the rest of the teams, and you know, if I could do it, you know, I mean, I think a lot of other people can. You know, so I just don't give up. Shine your light down on me.
Lift me up so I can see. Shine your light when you're gone. Give me the strength to carry on, carry on. No wanna be a hero, just an everyday man. Trying to do the job, the very best he can.